Hello everyone, my name is Victor.
Hi everyone, my name is Yaya.
And we are the Kingdom Brothers.
Hi, hello guys. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to any one of you who watch our episode today from all over the world. Thank you so much for watching. And today, welcome back to our episode number 4. So today we'll be talking about the books that we have read, which inspire us, which actually empower us to do a lot of wonderful things in our lives lah. Maybe I can start first.
Yep, go ahead, bro.
So I would like to really talk about a good friend of ours. She is none other than Millie Leong.
Millie's international best-selling book, Mind and Money Makeover, reveals a 5-step proven system that will transform your life and take you to living your dreams. Thousands of copies sold. She is currently a 7-figure business entrepreneur turned business and marketing strategist and mentor for women entrepreneurs.
Her book is really very fantastic. I really like to read her entire book, and her last chapter was all about gratitude. And that really fits me very well, resonate me very well, because I really love to be say thank you and say be grateful to all the people whom I have connected with, and to the abundance that have already fallen in my life. And I'm so grateful for that to happen. And I really thank you to God, to the universe, and to also to karma, to whoever you want to be grateful for. Just say thank you to them. It's not, you don't have to be be person, you know? You don't have to be there in front of the person to say thank you. You can just say it to yourself, or say it to the air, to the sky. Look up at the sky and say thank you. Be grateful for that person who have come to your life, or be grateful for that person who really helped you. And the last chapter of Millie Leong's book really really talks about how you can be grateful, and that really resonate with me. And really thank you so much, Millie Leong, for writing that book. And the last chapter really impact me, and she has reminded me how to be grateful every day. And right now, every day I have been saying my thanks every morning and every night, being so that I know that I expecting myself that abundance will come, more abundance will come to me lah in my life. So that's how I feel that Millie Leong's book have really impacted my life in that way. Yeah. So thank you, Millie Leong. I'm very grateful now. Thank you so much for writing that book. So what about you, Victor, my friend?
Well, I think there's really a lot of selection for me personally, but I think the one particular book that really stood out, you know, during my first few years of, you know, actively doing reading and personal development, definitely, you know, is this book titled The Unemployed Millionaire by Mr. Matt Morris, you know, my brother from another mother. Shout out to you, my bro, for writing that book. Truly appreciate it. So this book, you know, the book's title was the one that really got my attention. It was, you know, The Unemployed Millionaire. I mean, the first thing that came to my mind when I first saw the title was that, how can you become a millionaire when you're unemployed? It just doesn't make sense to me. It doesn't make sense. Then that really caught my attention, and I really went in, you know, in depth into the book and read. And in particular, one chapter, I can't remember which chapter it was, but it left such a deep impression on me. It basically is to, you know, ask us to list down, I think it was 50 to 100, you know, of the most craziest things that you ever want in your life. 50 to 100 craziest thing ever. Because what he touched on so beautifully in the book was that most of us, when we were born out into this world, we were taught, you know, to dream small. I mean, if you look at it from another perspective, when you were as a child, when you are young, you're basically, your thinking, your dream has no limitation. I mean, you say that you want to become an astronaut, you want to become, you know, a fireman, a lawyer, a doctor. The possibility is endless. You just You just say that, oh, you know, you dare to dream when you were a child, all right? But as you grow older, and when you start to go out into society and work, what happens to that? I mean, basically, there's something called reality. Reality hits in, and you will start to think that, oh, you know what? I don't think I'm able to, you know, fulfill my goals, my dreams, my aspiration. So Matt Morris, in that chapter, he particularly reminded all of us, you know, to start to dream big again. I mean, dream big, dream crazy, you know. And I remember it took me a really long time to really write down that 50 to 100 things, because I've never really been a very ambitious person to even begin with in the very beginning. So it really was a torture for me to write that 50 to 100 things, really, really torture. But, you know, thank God I managed to persist on, and I wrote it down. And when I actually look back at it and see the things that I really wanted to do, I was like, it's pretty interesting. I mean, it's like, just to name some of the crazy things that I say I wanted to do is like, you know, to go skydiving in Dubai, to, you know, swim with sharks, you know, in the cage. I mean, in the cage, of course, not open water. I mean, in the cage. Then, what else? Let me see. I'll do paragliding, you know, go trek Mount Everest, you know, and do so many, many things that most people wouldn't even dare to dream of. I mean, so he really reminded me, you know, through that chapter to really go out there and just keep on dreaming, dream big. Because there is the only limitation you can place is on yourself is you. You are the only one that can place the limitation on yourself, right? So for that, I really, you know, thank Matt Morris, you know, for writing that book. And that particular chapter really, really stood out to me. How about you, bro? Any crazy things?
The craziest thing I've ever done, right, is to walk across Singapore from Tuas Road 60 all the way to Changi Village, which took me about 26 to 27 hours. With breaks in between. That was like in 2012, I think. Yeah, 2012. Yeah, the next craziest thing I've done is to... I've not done any crazy thing lately, but I think of course right now the craziest thing that I am doing right now with Victor is creating this brand new channel for you guys to come and, you know, watch our topics, watch our discussion, watch our reminders of life lah. Yeah, by sharing our experience, by sharing other people's experience also. Yeah. So I hope that you find that this crazy thing that we are doing right now is worth it. And please subscribe to our channel, like and comment. And
yep.
Yeah, and maybe you would like to recommend books that you have read to us.
Please.
Yep.
Yeah, let us know if you have read, you know, any books that have really inspired you and has made a huge and lasting impact in your life, you know, so that we can be blessed also to go and read that book. So we will continue, you know, regularly in our episodes, you know, we will share with you some of the books that we have read and what kind of impact, you know, it has made on our life. All right, so I mean, I just want to end off with this quote that I believe some of you guys would have heard of from Walt Disney. I mean, of course, the guy who created the biggest dream in the world, Disneyland. He says, if you can dream it, you can do it too. With that, thank you so much, and we will see you on episode 5. God bless.
Bye-bye.
Hey, Victor. Hey, Yaya. Hi, this is Millie. I heard you guys are making a video and you're going to be talking about my book. So I thought I'll make a quick video and say hello to all of you and also to your audience. First of all, thank you, Yaya, for picking my book as one of your favorite books. And this is my best-selling book, Mind and Money Makeover, How to Transform Your Life in 3 Years or Less and Live Your Dreams. Now, a little bit of a backstory. Actually, when I wrote this book, it took me a really long time. And in fact, the first draft I came up with after 15 months, I didn't like it at all, and I scrapped the whole thing and rewrote the entire book again. So it actually took me a really long time, but I'm glad that I got it out, became an international best-selling book, sold thousands of copies, and got a lot of great feedback on the book. So I hope you guys will also like this book. So enjoy it. And in the meantime, I want to say thank you again, Yaya and Victor. You guys are doing awesome. You guys are stepping out of your comfort zone. You're definitely turning your mess into a beautiful message, and you're going to shine and impact the world. So very proud of you guys. Continue to shine, and I look forward to seeing you very soon. Alrighty. Thank you so much again. Talk to you soon. Bye bye.